Hi guys, welcome back to Fun to Learn with Dora Shang and Xander. I just picked up my new sewing machine and I'm going to unbox it and review it today. Right, let's open it. Ooh, this is really exciting. Wow. Oh my goodness. So it is a DC305O Decor Computer Janome sewing machine. It looks so exciting. Wow, these are the instructions. This is my new Janome sewing machine. So excited. Oh my goodness, this is so cool. I'll show you some of the parts of it. So, this is the flywheel.
You can push it out. I'm not sure if this one you can push out.
Well, anyway, you turn the flywheel. And as this is the other way round, you will turn it towards you. If you turn it away from you, it immediately shortens the lifespan of your sewing machine by 1/3. So make sure you don't do that. This is where you hook your thread onto your main thread, and then you'll thread it round there, down this bit, up there. You'll turn the flywheel towards you, so a little silver thing will come up. You hook it around the silver thing, you go down, you hook it,
hook it through there, here, and then through the
needle. So cool. And then the bobbin, so just lift it up. There we go. So this little button here lifts up and down the pedal foot, like so. And if I just do this, pull this thing away from me, this will come out. And the bobbin, this is not a threaded bobbin, but I'd need to re-thread the bobbin. And that's where.
So now I have unboxed it, and this is what I've got. And all I need to do to set it up is two simple things. So I've got my foot pedal here, and this is the wire connecting to the foot pedal, and this is the switchboard. So I will put this in this hole. Ta-da! And that's the foot pedal done. And next, the wire. I think that's it. And ta-da! That was super easy, wasn't it? That's all you need to do. And then you need to switch it on. And like the switchboard, you switch it on. And then a light will appear. And you should see a number 01 appear here. Now, I'm going to show you how to thread a bobbin.
I have my thread here ready.
And I'm going to take my bobbin out. So I just use this very simple blackboard here. It's lined, and all you need to do is slide it, and then this will pop out. Just take this out, and you're left with the bobbin. It's very, very easy. You just slide your finger under here and get the bobbin out. I'll put this back in like that. So now I'm going to put my thread inside this, like so, and so it's attached now. Then I will take a piece of thread and cork it round this little screw and then my bobbin. It will go on the top. As you can see, my bobbin has four little holes. It will go through the top of one of them. This is hard. How on earth am I going to get it through? And then I'm going to put my bobbin on the top here until it clicks down. And then I will just slowly push it to the side, to the right hand side. Then I will hold this excess piece of string. I will press the on button on my switchboard here so that it lights up and it shows SP. Then I will take my foot pedal and just slowly press down on it. And there we go. It should start sewing, refilling your bobbin. It should stop when I'm done automatically. So that would be good. So I'm just going to keep on holding down the foot pedal. Oh, it's slowing down. Looks like it's almost done. It's growing fatter and fatter by the minute. Wow. As you can see, it's turning. The string is turning and the bobbin is turning and it just works so amazingly. So my bobbin is almost full. And it stopped. Well done, sewing machine, well done. Now I forgot to tell you one minute little detail, but it's of great importance. Before you start, you need to put this onto the highest speed with the three arrows. Now my bobbin is full, I'm going to put it inside the sewing machine. So once again, I will turn this, I will move this blackboard towards the right, take this out, and this time insert the bobbin in. Now, it should be like a P shape with the thread hanging down on the left. And I'll just put that in there. And then I will slide that through that silver bit there until it's hanging out. Now I shall do the thread. One of the best things I love about this machine is that it has a built-in needle threader. I'm going to show you how to use that right now. First of all, I will need to thread this to the machine though. So I will put my main thread through the spool. I will hook it here, attach it, take a long piece of thread, like so. And then, using these little pictures to guide me, I will hook this piece of thread round there, go all the way down, and all the way back up, till I'm right here. And then I will turn the flywheel, which is here, towards me, until, as you'll see, there's a silver thing popping up. I will hook it around the silver thing, and if you can see here, I'll go through there, all the way down, and then this little silver thing, I will go inside there, and then hook it to this silver thing. And instead of going to the needle, then I will have to put the presser foot down using this little black thing here. It's down now. And using the flywheel again, I will have to turn my needle up to its highest point. Well, let me do that again then. There we go. And then here's the amazing built-in needle threader. So push this down so it supports it. Oh, okay. So it supports the needle. And using this thread here, I will hook this round through there and underneath there, and then slowly let go. Have got stuck. There we go. And as you can see, there's a little loop at the back. And all you need to do is pull that loop Oh no, I think it broke. Oh, it broke the string. I'll do it again. So I'll just pull this. Okay, I'll have to start from the beginning. So I've gotten down to this stage again, and all I need to do is very gently put this down, hook the string around there, up there, and gently let go. Where is it? There's the loop. Which you just gently pull. Ta-da! Your needle is threaded. And that is the masterwork of the built-in needle threader. Now my machine is threaded. The main stitch having the red thread and the bobbin having the brown thread. I'm going to show you how to draw up the bobbin. First of all though, my presser foot will need to be up, so I'll just take this black thing here and pull it up, and there we go, the presser foot's up. So now we need to, because this amazing machine has its such cool digital functions, all I need to do is switch on the machine, hold the red thread and press it twice, and then pull. And there we go. You can see the brown thread coming up. And then all you'll need to do is take that brown thread. So now I've got my threads here, and I'm just going to put them out to the side. And then my foot is raised already. And then I'll just slide my piece under, put the presser foot down, turn the flywheel towards me so the needle is down, and then I'll start sewing on the slowest speed. Get the head on and start. Oh, the This is slow. Nice. Let's do with some speed. That's more like it. And that's it. I've sewn a line. There is my very, 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 well, almost straight line. And there's the red. And there's the brown. Ta-da! It's just like magic. Don't worry. Don't worry, I'll be back. I'm going to show you the rest of the amazing functions of my amazing sewing machine, including all the stitches, including this reverse button, including this bit. And don't forget to watch me making clothes using the sewing machine. Bye! Don't forget to subscribe, press like if you like this video, comment in the comments below, and click for my next new videos. Bye!